हेलो गाइस, दिस इज शिव एंड टुडे विल डिस्कस अबाउट अवर थर्ड प्रोग्राम अंडर द टॉपिक क्यू, दैट इज डी क्यू डबल एंडेड क्यू यूजिंग एरे इन सी प्रोग्रामिंग। सो फर्स्ट वी विल डिस्कस द फ्लो ऑफ द प्रोग्राम एंड आफ्टर दैट विद द हेल्प ऑफ ए आउटपुट ऑफ दैट प्रोग्राम वी विल अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट इज डी क्यू एंड हाउ डी क्यू वर्क। ओके गाइस, सो लेट्स स्टार्ट। So we will write vi q dash 3 dot c. So this is our program name. So now I will press enter button. So this is our program. So here first I commented q3 because it is our third program under the topic q, and subject is input and output restricted dq double ended q using array in C. Okay guys, so basically let me tell you, DQ is two type, means double ended queue is two type, input and output restricted. In input restricted queue we can do insertion in the queue from one side, but deletion can be done at any side in the queue, that is from the front or rear. Same for the output restricted. In output restricted we can do the deletion at one end only in the queue, but insertion can be done at any side from the front and rear. So this is the restriction in the input and output restricted. So as I will explain the code to you and I will show you the example, you will when I will run the program, then you will understand it better. Okay guys, so first let me explain you. So here I am including the stdio.h, stdlib.h and this is our macro max which has the value 5, means maximum 5 element can be inserted in the DQ. And this is our DQ array, here we are passing the macro max. Okay guys, so here we are taking the two variable left and right, which we will use as a index for the DQ array. Here this is the method display queue to display the DQ element, and this is the method for the main menu for the DQ. So these are the declaration of the method. Okay guys, so here next is insert write. So this is the method, I will come here as per the flow of the program. So this is the insert write method, after that insert left, after that delete left and delete right. These are the four method, and after that there is a display queue method to display the DQ element. This is the body of the method. And next is input queue. This is the queue input restricted. I will come here, just wait. And this is the output queue, means a output restricted DQ. Okay guys, so and this is the main menu method, this is the body of the method, and this is our main method. From here our execution of the program will start. So in the main method we are calling main menu method, so control will come here in the main menu. In the main menu first I am writing system clear. So to clear the terminal we are here reset the DQ array index to -1, means we are giving the value to left and right integer variable -1. Okay, for a DQ index means to empty the DQ. Okay guys, this is the choice integer variable. Here we are taking the label for go to statement repeat, and here some designing, for designing we are giving some line so that output should look good. And here we are printing the heading input and output restricted DQ, and then we are asking, we are giving the option to the user input restricted DQ, output restricted DQ. So here we are giving some value 1 and 2, and for third it will be exit from the program. So this menu will be shown to the user, and accordingly user will enter the value 1, 2 or 3. So we will call the respected method for that. So here we are asking enter your choice, 1, 2, 3, any value user can enter. Okay guys, so as user will enter their choice, so here there is a switch statement. So as per the user will enter the value, we will call the case. So for first, if user will enter 1, then we will call the input queue. For value 2, output queue we will call, and for 3 we will clear the terminal and come out of the program. We are calling the exit method with value 0. And if a user will enter any other value 1, 2, 3 in the main menu, then first we will clear the terminal, and we will print the message wrong choice, and we'll call the go to statement, and control will go to this label repeat. This is the control jump to the repeat label. Okay, so repeat is here, as I shown you here. Control will come here, and again same menu will be displayed to the user in the case of if user will enter the wrong choice other than 1, 2, 3. If he will enter 4 or 5, then again this menu will be shown to the user along with the method wrong choice, means along with the message wrong choice. Okay guys, so if user will enter the input queue, then control, means if user will enter the choice first, then input queue method will be called. So control will go to this input queue. So let me show you, this is our body of the input queue. So here we are calling the system clear to clear the terminal. Variable choice infinite loop with while, we are passing 1, so it will run for the infinite time. Here for designing, we are giving some line heading, we are printing input restricted DQ, and giving some option to the user what he wants. So for value 1, 2, 3, like that, we are giving some option to him, user. So we are giving some option insert at right, delete from left, delete from right, display, main menu, quit. We will ask a choice from the user, we will take input from the user, and we'll call the switch statement and accordingly as per the choice of the user we will call this method: insert right, delete left, delete right, display DQ, main menu, exit from the program with system clear, and default system clear, and wrong choice in the case of if a user will enter other than 1 to 6. If he will enter any other value, then we will give this message wrong choice. Okay guys, so same, if a user will, in the main menu, if user will enter the choice 2, then control will go to this case 2, and we will call this output queue method. So let me show you, this is output queue. Same for as a input queue, we will do here. First we will clear the terminal. There is a variable choice infinite while loop, some designing, we are giving some line heading output restricted DQ, menu for the user, insert at right, insert at left, delete from left, display, main menu, quit, and whatever enter will user will enter the choice 1, 2, 3 here, enter your choice. User will enter their choice and we will call here switch statement. And as per user will enter the value, we will call these cases. So for the first case, we will call insert right. Second case, insert left, delete left, display DQ, main menu, system clear to clear the terminal, exit from the program for the case 6. And for the default, if user will enter any other value from 1 to 6, then we will print the message wrong choice. Okay guys, so these are the two method which will be called from the main menu. So these two method has been covered. This you know to come out of the program and wrong choice in the case of any other value from 1 to 3. So as we have seen here, output queue, we are calling some methods, insert right, insert left, like that. Similarly for input queue, we are calling some method, insert right, insert left. So let me discuss these method one by one. So this is our first method, insert right. If this method has been called from the switch statement, then what we will do, clear the terminal, variable added item. First we will check during the insertion that DQ overflow is there or not, means if DQ is full or not. If it is full, then no need to insert any element. So this is the condition. Left variable is equal to 0 and right equal to max minus 1, or left equal to right plus 1. So this means that the queue is overflow, so we will return from here and execution will not proceed further. So if this is, this condition is false, then we will check if left is equal to minus 1, then it means that queue is empty. So we will make the value left and right equal to 0, so that first element can be inserted here. In the else condition, if queue is not empty, then we will check if right is equal to max minus 1, means right is at the last position of the DQ. So we will make right equal to 0, else right equal to right plus 1, because at this index, in the value of right, in this index we will insert the element. Okay, so we will give the message input the element for adding in queue, in DQ. Okay guys, so user will enter their value, through scanf we will take in added item, and here added item will be inserted at this index in the DQ array, at this index in the right value, whatever right value we will get from here. Okay guys, and we will display the array. Okay, so let me show you this display DQ method. Yes, this is our display DQ method. Here we are first, we will clear the terminal and whatever the value of left and right, we will take in the local variable these values, front pause, rear pause, means front position, rear position. Here first we are checking that DQ is empty or not. If DQ is empty, then no need to show the element. So if left is equal to minus 1, that's mean that DQ is empty, and we will return from here and code will not proceed further. Okay guys, if this is false, means your DQ is not empty, then we will give message DQ elements and we'll check condition. If front position less than equal rear position, then we will run the while loop. In while loop, front position less than equal rear position. Okay, if this condition is true, till this condition is true, then we will print the DQ array element. Okay, so here we are printing some open bracket, for the array symbol, and this is the close bracket for the array symbol. So between open and close bracket we will display the DQ element, okay, to give the feel of the array in the output, and we will increment the front position. Okay guys, so if this condition is false, then we will go in the else condition. In else again there is a while loop, front position less than equal max minus 1, same logic we will repeat here. And if this condition is false, then we will make front position equal 0, and again while loop, another while loop will be called until this condition will be true. Front position less than equal rear position, again same logic we will follow. And when we will come out of the this else condition, then we will print the new line, means new line will be there. Okay guys, so this is for the display. So we were here in the insert write. So insert write method has been completed, because in the last there was called display queue method, DQ method. So another method is insert left, same logic. To clear the terminal, variable added item will check overflow condition. This is the overflow condition, DQ overflow, then we will return from here, code will not proceed. If this condition is false, then we'll check. If it is empty, then we will make left and right equal to 0 to denote the 0th index of the array, because array start from the 0th index. In the else if condition, if left equal to 0, then left will equal to max minus 1, otherwise left equal to left minus 1. We will ask from the user, input the element for adding in DQ. We'll take the element from the user, that element will be inserted at this index in the DQ array at this left value, okay, and left value we will get from here, these three places. And again we will call the display DQ to display the DQ array. Okay, so another method is delete left, same logic. Clear the terminal, will check underflow condition. Underflow means if a DQ is empty, then there is no element to delete. So we are checking that condition, that if left equal to minus 1 means that DQ is empty. So we will print the method DQ underflow and will return from here, and code will not proceed further. Okay guys, and if this condition is false, then we will print the message element deleted from the DQ, and this is the whatever the left value, that will be that at that index that element will be deleted for the delete left. Okay, so if left equal to right means DQ has only one element, so we will reset the DQ array index, will make the left and right equal to minus 1, these two value. Okay, so and DQ array will become the empty in this case, means if left and right values minus 1, means array value start from the 0, not minus 1, so minus 1 will denote the empty array. Okay guys, so in the else if condition, if left equal to max minus 1, then left value will be 0, otherwise left equal to left plus 1. And again we will display the DQ array by calling this method display DQ, which I have already explained to you. Okay guys, so our next method is delete write, same logic. We'll clear the terminal, we'll check underflow condition, left equal to minus 1, then we'll print the method DQ underflow, and will come out of the program by call this return statement, and code will not proceed further. If underflow condition is false, we will proceed further, give the message element deleted from the DQ is DQ array and at this index. Delete write means write whatever the value of the write variable at this index we will print here the value to delete from the right. And if left equal to right, then there is a one element, so we will empty the DQ array by assigning the value to left and right variable -1. If right equal to 0, then right will equal to max -1, will provide the value this right variable. And if in the else condition, in the else part, right will equal to right -1, and again we will call this method to display the DQ array element. Okay guys, and display I have already covered. I have already explained this method to you, display DQ, so I will not repeat. So I think I have explained all the method to you. So I think code explanation is completed. So first let me show you one picture to you to understand DQ visually. Okay, so this is our DQ means a double ended queue. So actually DQ is categorized in two category, input restricted and output restricted. If we are calling the input restricted DQ, then input means insertion will be happen at one end only, means we will make the restrictions condition for the insertion that it will happen only one end, but deletion can be happen at any end in the input restricted. So in the input restricted, insertion will happen always from the rear side, means insertion will be happen from the rear side, from the right side, but deletion can be happen from both sides, from the rear and from the left. So that is input restricted DQ. And in the output restricted DQ, we will make the restrictions for the deletion. That deletion will happen only from the one end of the DQ, but insertion can be happen from the any side. So in output restricted DQ, deletion will always be happen from the front side. Deletion will always happen from the front side, from this side, but insertion can be happen from any side, from front and rear. Okay, so that is our DQ. So now let's run the program and we can understand through the output of our program how DQ work. So let me come out of the program. Now we will first compile. We'll write GCC q3.c-o q3. So our program is compiled successfully. So now let's run the program. So we'll write q3. I will press the enter button. So this is our program. So this is adding input and output restricted DQ. So there is some option, input restricted DQ, output restricted DQ. To exit we can press 3. So first I will show you input restricted DQ. So I will enter the one through my keyboard and I will press enter button. So now we will get heading input restricted DQ. So here there are 6 options: insertion at right, deletion from left, deletion from right, display, main menu, quit. Okay guys, so as I told you, in input restricted we can insert the element in the double ended queue from the one side, from the rear, that is the right side, but deletion can be happen at any side, front and rear, that is from left and right. Okay guys, so first I will enter the 4 because there is no element. So let me see what output will come. So it is showing DQ is empty. Okay, because there is no element. Suppose that I am entering 2 because there is no element, DQ is empty. So I am trying to delete from the left. it is showing DQ underflow because there is no element to delete. Okay guys, so if I'm entering the 3, so same value I will get. I am trying to delete from the right, so I am enter 3 for this. So same output we are getting, DQ underflow. So let's insert some value in our input restricted DQ. So I am pressing 1. So it is asking input the element for adding in DQ. So I am entering 11. I am pressing enter. So here we are getting DQ elements 11. So one element is in our DQ this time. Again I am entering another value. So since insertion is happening at the right side, so another value will come after 11. Okay, let me show you. I am entering 22. Okay, so right side. So from the right side element will be added. So let me add more element. 33 44 55. Now 5 element has been completed. So if I will enter another element, then it will show some message. Okay, DQ overflow means we have given the maximum 5 value can be inserted in the code in the macro max. So that's why more than 5 element cannot be inserted in it. Okay guys, so here we can see DQ overflow. Okay, so let me enter 4 to display the element. So we have 5 element here, so means we can't insert more. So now we have option to delete from the left and from the right. So first I will enter 2 to delete from the left side. Left means this is the front side and this is the rear side. Okay, so left means 11 will be gone. So I am entering, I am pressing enter button. So you can see 11 has gone from the left side. Again I will enter 2, so 22 will be gone. You can see. So now I want to delete from the right side, means from this side, from the rear side. So 55 will be gone. So I will enter the 3 and press enter button. 55 gone. Okay guys, again 3, 44 will be gone. So like this our deletion and insertion will work in the input restricted DQ. Okay guys, so again I will enter 3 from the right, so 33 will be gone. So DQ is empty. So if I will enter again to delete any element, I will enter 3, press enter, DQ underflow because there is no element. So input restricted DQ is empty this time. Okay, if I will enter 4, DQ is empty. So this is the functionality of DQ, means input restricted DQ. So let me go to our main menu. So I will enter 5. So this is our main menu. So now I will go to the output restricted DQ. So I will enter 2. So here we can see some heading, output restricted DQ. So here we have option insert at right, insert at left, delete from left, display main menu, quit. So as I told you, in output restricted DQ restriction is at the deletion, means a deletion will always happen from the front of the DQ, means from the left side, but insertion can be happen at any side, from left and right. So here you can see. So here first I will try to delete. So I will enter 3 and press enter. So you can see message DQ underflow because there is no element. I will enter 4, DQ is empty. Okay, so let me insert some element. So I will enter 1 and my choice is 1. So I will press enter button. It will ask input the element for adding in DQ. So I will enter 11. So element has been added. So let me insert again one element. So I will enter 1. So element will be added from the right side, means another element will be come after 11, means here 12 will come. So let me show you. I will enter 12. Okay, so from right side element is added. Again let me show you. I will enter 13. From the right side element are added. So now I want to one element add to the left side, means before 11. So I will enter 2. Okay, So I will enter 14. So before 11 it has come, 14 has come before 11 from the left side. Okay, so again I want to enter another element at the left side, so I will enter 2, my choice is 2. I will enter 15. So 15 has been added before 14. So insertion is happening at from the left side. So we have completed our F5 element. So if I will enter again, so now I will try insert from the right side. So let me show you what message will come. Queue overflow, DQ overflow. Okay, so maximum limit is 5 element can be inserted, so that's why we can't insert more than 5 here. Okay, so let me enter 4. So we have 5 element this time completed. So now I will delete one by one all element, and deletion will be happen from the left side only. We have only one option from left side, means from this side element will be deleted one by one. So let me show you. I will enter 3. So 15 will be gone. Again 14 gone, 11, 12, 13, all element has been gone. Okay guys, so if I will try to delete again, I will enter my choice 3. DQ underflow message I have got, we have got. Okay, so if I will try 4 to display the array element, DQ is empty. Okay guys, so that was the two type, input and output restricted. So let me enter 5. Okay guys, so guys I have covered the DQ, which is two type, input restricted and output restricted DQ. So if I will enter any other value other than here 1, 2, 3, then it will show the message wrong choice. Okay guys, so guys I think you got the idea what is DQ and how DQ work, and what is the functionality of input restricted, what is the functionality of output restricted. So do practice. Thank you so much. Bye bye.